Hey, what's up, y'all? Rossi here for American Airgunner, and man, do I have a surprise for you guys. You know, being an American Airgunner, I always get to see things first, know about things first, shoot things first, and sometimes end up in places where there's crazy windstorms and all of our equipment is blowing down behind you. But that's not gonna stop me from the good news that is going down today. We are in Mesa, Arizona at Rio Salado Gun Club. You guys have probably seen us here before. This is the home of extreme bench rest. This is where I've come to win that competition a couple times. I mean, compete in that competition a couple times. I've never won anything out here. But one day, I was lucky enough to be invited out because there's a new gun out and they've just come on board. This new gun manufacturer's come on board to be part of the American Airgunner family. And so I was able to get flown out to check out this new gun that by the time this video is airing, you can go buy. But as far as when I'm shooting this, where I'm shooting it, and how I'm shooting it, there's like three of them. So I had to come out. They wouldn't ship it to me. I'm not that important. So are you ready? Are you guys ready for this? Are you ready? Brace yourselves. Oh, there it is. This, my friends, is the Western Airguns Rattler. And by Rattler, that means it will bite you in the face. I mean, this thing is hot. It's a, you're not gonna believe it. It's a 357, 9mm. It shoots pellets, 80 grain pellets from JSB, of course. 357 pellet, like, hello, right? That's a chunk of lead right there. This gun, when it is fully jazzed up, pushed up to its full pressure, it shoots an 81 grain JSB pellet at over 1,000 feet per second. So you're getting some serious speed. It's about, I think it works out to be around 180 foot-pounds at those speeds. But here's the beauty, that's not all. It shoots those things. It also shoots these. Slug gun, pellet gun. It comes ready for slugs, right? We love slugs. That's the new thing, air guns. We love to shoot slugs, right? Because that makes them more powerful. They're great for hunting. You make sure you take every animal you go after humanely because there's no question you're shooting a, what, this is a hundred and almost, it's like 174, 175 grain slug. You're gonna get 780 feet per second on 174 grain slug. That's 230 foot-pounds. At that power, that cranked up as much power as you can get out of this gun to shoot this 174 grain slug, you still get a full magazine. You get 15 shots regulated at 230 plus foot-pounds. Boom! I mean, is this a hunting gun or what? The thing with this gun is you do not want to go to the unregulated side of things. Because it's semi-auto, you need air pressure for it to recycle itself or to cycle itself so you can keep pulling the trigger. If you go past that and you're it's just not fun. You could end up out in the woods with no working gun. So you want to be very aware of this gun. This is a work of art. I mean, this is a piece of art, but built heavy enough, built strong enough, you can take it out of the field, do some damage, do some good hunting. Let's take a look at this thing. First of all, I mean, it's got that sleek, black, very tough looking, right? It's a good looking gun. It's all metal, aluminum, stainless steel. Everything in here is tough, built well. It's got some, cheek piece here's probably some sort of composite or something. Again, not a whole lot of changes to be made back here in the back, but there's a whole aftermarket for this world, right? AR grip, you can change that out to be whatever you want. You can see it's got accessory rails here on the side, on the top, on the bottom, 550 cc carbon fiber tank, so you have plenty of shots. The way it comes, where it's shooting the pellets at 880 feet per second, you get about 50 shots per fill. But here's the beauty, guys. See this right here? Safe. And see what this says? Semi. It is a semi-automatic 357 shooting pellets or slugs out of a, there's a couple different barrel variations here. It comes ready for slugs, right? So I believe this setup right here, it's got a 1-in-20 twist rate, which is ideally set up for slugs, shooting better at long distance. But then there's also a 1 in 26 where you can get in, which shoots slugs and pellets. That's something you can decide when you buy this gun, because you're going to buy this gun once you see me pull the trigger. But overall, a trigger, not adjustable. Again, it's kind of a what you see is what you get. There's a little bit of play in it, but again, it's pretty smooth as far as I'm concerned. I'm not one of those weird trigger people. Like, if it has a trigger and I can pull it, puts a smile on my face. So that's what I love about it. Everything else, looking at it, it's got all the bare necessities that you want in an air gun, right? It's pretty good. It shoulders well. It's not too heavy, not too light. It's heavy enough to where it's going to stabilize itself to get good accuracy. Again, this is a powerful gun. This is a hunting gun. This is something you're going to go out and hunt. I mean, in some states, legally, with the foot pounds it's putting out, I believe you could hunt big game. But, you know, you got to check state to state. But for the most part, anything, pig, coyotes, goats, large wolves in states that it's legal, like, this thing would be a great gun. You're not taking this to like a shooting competition. As you can see, it's a shrouded barrel. It's baffled here at the end. This is not a removable silencer, if you will, but it's got a whole baffle system from here to here, and then obviously it's got a nice shroud here on the barrel. It's full barrel. It's not a bullpup anymore. It's a 24-inch barrel, so you're getting good speeds. Regular set at 150. You can adjust the regular here, but at this gun, from what I've been told, and I'm not gonna lie, I've tweaked with it a little bit, even though they told me not to, I did. But you don't get any more power adjusting the regular, so it's better just kind of leave it at 150. What you do have back here is a power wheel. You turn it clockwise, you get more power. You turn it counterclockwise, you get less power. So you can move it 300-400 feet per second with these pellets. I mean, depending on what you're shooting, how fast you want to shoot, there's a lot of variable speed here that you can change this to. So you can crank it down for pellets. You can crank it up because you're going from an 81 grain to a 180 grain. There's the other side, Western Air Guns. They are a new sponsor of American Air Gunner, which means you are going to get a chance to see this gun in action on American Air Gunner this upcoming season. We're going to go do some hunting with this gun. Just so you know, this is one thing that might throw some of you off. MPA, it's 10, 0, 10, 20, 30 MPA. 10 MPA is 100 bar. 20 is 200, 30 is 300. Why they went with MPA? I don't know. Just because air guns aren't confusing enough, so it's always fun to throw in another, you know, measurement of air in there, because we're all very familiar with our air measurements. I know I am. It says here after 30 or after 300 bars where the red zone is, but I was told not to fill it up past 250. I'm sure when I'm out of here and I have my own gun, I'll probably. But just don't tell anybody, because then if you break it, you got to send it back and they're going to blame me. And I'm going to say, well, the red zone, you know, what are you going to do? That's not the point. The point is MPA 10 equals 100 bar. Got it? Standard male Foster right here. So ease the air up. It's right there. So you don't have to have like the super long hose and the connector that, oh, I put the wrong one in there. I'm stuck. Like, you just, it's right there. Like, fill it up and move on. And this is my favorite part. It's like they listen to air gunners. They put the place where you fill it up right next to the place that tells you how much air's in it. Right, so you don't have to fill it up on one side and then turn the gun up so far and then look down the barrel, you know, they got them at the end and all that crap. It's like right there, which to me makes a lot of sense. The people they're making the guns for us, almost by us, right, for the air gunners. So here we go. Flip this up. That allows the magazine to spin. All right, so that slides up just like that, and now this can spin. I want to show you the difference here, right, because I think this is very important to understand, right? This is an 80 grain pellet. This is a 174 grain slug, right? Big difference. This, it comes standard in this gun, shooting at 880 feet per second. You can push it up over 1,000 feet per second. I've done it, and this thing pops. This one, when you crank it up to where you're shooting this pellet at 1,000 feet per second, at the same time, then you'll be shooting this slug fully cranked up at around 780 feet per second. 783, you know, 768, somewhere right there. But it's, you know, not 63, 70, 73. The only time you really lose a little bit, where you maybe see like 20, a change of 20 feet per second, is when you're like rattling them off semi-auto as fast as you can, because it needs the air to kind of recycle. If you take your time, you get that same power over time. But want to make sure that you guys are clear. So it has to be fully cranked up to get this one to go 780, but that pushes this one over 1,000. If you want to bring this one down to 880, this one's not, you're not probably going to shoot slugs. You're going to, when you put a slug in, you're gonna re-crank it up. This gun is cranked up, so it's gonna shoot these pellets at over 1,000 feet per second, and then I'm gonna get maximum power out of the slugs at this 174 grain slug at around 780 feet per second. So let's start with some pellets, shall we? A lot of the magazines, a lot of the concepts, we see them kind of repeat themselves with air guns. I mean, there's only so many combinations you can do, right? You gotta figure out how to put the pellet or slug in the magazine. The magazine's gotta hold it, and it's gotta cycle the way it cycles. So, and I know you're all gonna, oh, come on! The magazine is not removable, right? So you get your 15 shots, but like I said, this is a hunting gun. This is a gun you're going to go out and do hunts with. If you can't get the job done with 15 shots, as accurate as this thing is, and shoot at the powers the thing is, maybe hunting's not for you. You know, maybe you need like a break barrel. I don't know. I don't know you. I'm just saying, for me, this is plenty. So then this slides back down. Now you're good, locked and loaded. Make sure to flip this back down here. And then you've got safety here, so safety semi, and then also right here on this side where my thumb is, there's a safety and a to go to fire. So it's kind of redundant, but redundant's good in this day and age. So I'm gonna flip this to semi. This is still unsafe up here, as you can see, safe, even though this is set, but now we're gonna flip it to fire. Here we go. So I've got some spinners at it. I've got some targets out at 25. I've got some targets out at 50. I got a big steel out at 100. I'm gonna have some fun. Enjoy yourselves. All right, here we go. We'll start with pellets first. I'm gonna go to the big target, the giant elephant. What's that thing like, 1 inch? All right, here we go. Got it. This is gonna be my 5-shot group, so wrap your head around it. Five shots, not bad. I would say they're all within this big because that's how big the targets were. Here we go, let's try it at 50. Oh my gosh, this thing is powerful. There's an elk out there. Nope, I'm low. There it is, 4 mil dots. Where is it? There it is. All right, moving over. I'm gonna get on those spinners and just stay on them until I hit what I want. Not a bad group right there, 50. All right, now here's for the best part. It's at 100, I'm not sure exactly where this thing's hitting 100, but there's a nice steel out there. Oh, there it is, we have a coyote. It's got a kill zone that's like tiny. I don't really care about the kill zone right now because here's what I wanna do. Oh, dead coyote, dead! You see it, so much power at 100 yards. With a pellet, it knocked the steel coyote off the berm. This is a giant piece of steel. I mean, this is a heavy piece of steel. Well, we just knocked the whole dadgum thing over. So I'm pretty sure that means I hit the kill zone at 100 yards of that thing with a pellet and knocked it over. That was just with pellets. Now it's slug time. I have a feeling I'm gonna break some of my targets, but it's gonna be worth it, shall we? Great thing about this magazine is, number one, it's really wide. I mean, you can see right here like how wide it is, so it fits this slug, right? So you can get a longer slug in there, which a lot of air guns, you try to do slugs, the magazines won't hold them. It's not the gun that's the problem, it's the magazine's the problem. But this one's made to shoot slugs, right? It's a hunting gun. But the other thing too, and the great thing about this magazine, even though you can't remove it, the plus to that situation is that it's kind of a metal on metal seal, the chamber seal, so you don't need O-rings. That magazine becomes part of the sealing chamber to shoot that slug. It creates a situation where there's less room for error, less chance of error. So same scope, I have changed nothing. I've just put slugs in. So we're gonna shoot it identically at what we just did with the pellets, which obviously they were very accurate at 25, very accurate at 50, and then very accurate at 100, even though I was kind of guessing where I was shooting, I still hit the target because that's kind of my thing. We're gonna do the same thing with the slugs. Now you're going from 1,045 feet per second to down to 780, you know, 770 to 785, somewhere around there. I think I'm gonna have to make some adjustments. Let's see, we'll start at 25 with the elephant, shall we? Get out of here. Two shots in the spinner and the whole dadgum target falls over. That's a lot of, this is a lot of power. This is a lot of power. Like I told you, it's the Rattler for a reason. That's the same hold at 50 yards with the slug. I doubted it. Okay, I just finished that one magazine. So 15 shots, 357 at 230 foot-pounds, around, you know, around 78 feet per second. And you can see I'm just below 200. I'm probably like 160. So there you go. Full 15 shots at full power, regulated, semi-auto. Enough said. All right, here we go. Coyote at 100. Like I said, I'm guessing 4 mil dots. That's a dead coyote. I mean, all right, that's it. 25, 50, 100 accuracy. The funny thing to me is right now, and again, there's not a whole lot of testing going in this. I'm just getting a chance to like see it and do a quick little video. But the fact that it's, for the most part, hitting at the same holds as the pellet, it's like a little bit lower. I would think it would be like considerably lower, and it doesn't seem to be. So obviously a lot of power. I got one more shot I gotta do before we wrap this thing up. So cinder block with the Firebird. I'm gonna see how quick I can blast through the cinder block and hit the Firebird on the other side. You guys time me, here we go. Full fill, full magazine, here's the challenge. Cinder block, how fast I can shoot through that cinder block and hit the Firebird on the other side of the entire cinder block. So two sides of the cinder block, gonna blow through both of them, then hit the Firebird. Let's see how fast I can do it, and then I'm gonna challenge you to do the same thing with your 357. Let's see if you can do it faster. Shots, maybe four. Here's the beauty, guys. That was with pellets. This gun's so powerful. I mean, this gun is absolutely amazing. It is powerful, it is semi-auto, it is fast-paced, it shoots slugs, it shoots pellets, it looks awesome. You can make the adjustments you want to make. There's some things you can't adjust, but I mean, for the most part, this gun, you're looking for a cool hunting gun, a good hunting gun, something you can really go out and shoot and get some serious firepower out of. Western Airguns Rattler. You can find more information about this gun at AmericanAirGunner.com. They are a new sponsor. Say hello to them, get to know them, and if you get a chance, get a Rattler. We got a video coming out. I'm gonna challenge you guys to something, but I wanna get some people together, and we may have a special giveaway coming up soon. So stay with us, go to all our social media channels and stay with us so you can figure out when that giveaway is gonna go down and maybe you can walk away with a Rattler. Thanks for watching. See you next time.